A message to Christian singles. Stop being ashamed for being single. Hey guys, what's up? It's Isaac, and if you're new to this channel is all about helping you walk with Jesus daily. That's why it's called Daily Disciple. I'm dealing with kind of a cold. I had a flu a little bit during the Christmas time, and now we're way past that, but I'm still dealing with cold symptoms and flu, so I feel a little bit sick, but nevertheless, I gotta get a video out for you today. This is a little bit of a rant I have, but it's for your encouragement. It's not to get you all angry or riled up, but I've been seeing, okay, I've been on this new app. It's not new, but it's new for me, TikTok, and on it, you know, there's mostly kids, probably I would say age 12 to 18. I'm 20, I'm on there, I post pretty often. So I'm a little bit older in the age range. But on there, you know, post a lot of funny, you know, short videos and that kind of thing. But I've noticed a lot of them are about, you know, being single. And oh man, I'm a hopeless single. Oh man, nobody likes me. Oh man, I'm single, I'm such a loser. Like, it's really interesting to see these videos. And I think it's a real reflection of a lot of people. Maybe you're in that age range too, maybe 12 to 18, or maybe even older than that, and you're just like, oh man, I'm single, especially when you get older. I'm 20. I haven't dealt with this tons just because I'm still, like, I would say 20 is still pretty young. When you get to that age range of maybe 22 or 23, maybe some of you guys can speak to this in the comments. Dude, it's so common to just be ashamed and feel insecure about being single. And I think we in the Christian community, we've done a lot of harm in this area. We've hurt a lot of people because of how high we value marriage. We're like, oh, marriage is the pinnacle. Oh man, two souls coming together as one. Oh my goodness, this is an amazing thing. And yet here, we're leaving all these people here that are in the pews and, oh yeah, they're single. Oh, they're 22, 23, even 20. And they're like, yeah, I'm not, you know, I'm not in a relationship. For me, I've never even been in a relationship. So I can relate to this. I don't claim to know a lot about relationships because I've never been in one, but I do know that the single experience, being single, there can be a lot of pressure from outside people, like people within the church community. I don't know. I know I'm kind of rambling because I'm half sick, but I see this as such a sad thing when we feel shame in this area of, oh man, yeah, I haven't found the person that I'm gonna, you know, spend the rest of my life with. Like, we're in this kind of holding zone, like, nothing really happens when you're single, and it's just kind of sad, and you're just kind of like, yeah, maybe one day something good will happen and I'll be in a relationship. Like, to me, that's such a sad, disoriented perspective of what life is like and what God has created the season of life to be like and be for, because when we are stuck in this area, in this state of shame, like we're ashamed of where we're at, or when we feel shame for being single, whatever it is, in my opinion, we're stifling our growth, and we're stifling and putting a hold to maybe what God would have for us during this season. When we're caught up in shame and self-pity and like, oh man, I wish I were in a relationship, it's so sad. Like, what are we missing out on? I think we're missing out on a whole lot of opportunities to just be like, hey, you know what? This is where I am. I don't need to make excuses. This is another thing too. So many people are making excuses here, stupid excuses. I know, you know, with, you know, parents or grandparents, usually they're like, are you in a relationship yet? And you just gotta say some stuff. But to me, like, can we stop with the stupid excuses? Yeah, I don't know. My schedule's just really busy. I can't even fit a relationship in. Yeah, I'm just focusing on school right now. School is my main priority. Yeah, man, I'm just kind of working on me right now. You know, that self-growth, self-development kind of. Okay, so if any of those excuses were true for you, that's fine, I'm glad. But I know a lot of people, they say those things to get people off their backs and that kind of thing. But believe me, the second that somebody kind of comes into your life, you're like, oh my goodness, this person is, you know, I like this person and this seems right and all this kind of thing. You're like, well, I'm busy. Well, whatever. I don't care that I'm busy. I'll fit this in, you know? So some of these excuses, maybe they can serve a purpose, and maybe from, you know, people that are putting pressure on you from the outside to get them kind of back off a little bit. But I want to encourage you to kind of be bold in the fact that, you know, not that I'm single and I don't need no, you know, some of these girls are like, I don't need no man, I'm a strong, independent woman. Like, that's not necessarily what I'm saying, but I'm saying that it's okay that you're single, guy, girl, whatever. It's okay that you're single, and you don't need to be ashamed of that. God doesn't want you to be ashamed of that, because when we are ashamed, we stop being useful, and we stop growing, and we stop moving. Okay, I want to address something here, too. I've seen a number of Christian singles, they find it a little too easily to find signs from God that it's His will for you to date somebody or be in a relationship with somebody. Oh my goodness, there's a new girl in Bible study. It's a sign. Yo, dude, she goes to the same grocery store as I do. It's a sign. Hey, man, she uses the same Bible translation as I do. It's a sign. Hey, I heard that his favorite worship song, get this, it's Waymaker. His favorite song is Waymaker. That's my favorite song too. It's a sign. Okay, so I don't pretend to know when the sign, like when there's a appropriate sign and like, oh my goodness, well, this person is this and this and this and this. It's a sign. Like, I don't even know. I don't know how that works. I've never been in a relationship. I'm not a relationship expert. All I know is that we should probably calm down in terms of the things that we attribute as signs. Oh my goodness, this person is in my university class. It's a sign. Like, let's chill. Okay, so maybe you're like, Isaac, yeah, I'm not ashamed of being single, you know, maybe I make excuses every once in a while for why it is, but at the end of the day, you know what, I'm okay with being single, and I'm not gonna be ashamed of it, but I still want to kind of be in a relationship eventually, I want to get married, and maybe you're in that zone, so I want to speak to that a little bit. Like I said, I don't claim to be an expert on any of this, or even know the first thing about relationships, but I do think, and maybe we're in this journey together, I do think an important thing is to look for community. So look for good, solid Christian community where you can meet people where they have, you know, you don't want identical beliefs because you want people, you want growth and you want all that kind of thing, but like similar beliefs, so like, you know, church group or whatever, people that have the same kind of foundation, and start establishing and trying to build that community around you and get into a community like that, because I hate to break it to you, and it was a very harsh reminder for me too, but you actually need to talk to the person that you want to be in a relationship with. Like, if you see somebody, you're like this person seems awesome, this seems cool, okay, great, you actually need to talk to that person. For me, I haven't got to that level yet. Maybe one day I'll keep you updated, but I think it's just funny. So find that community. Don't be ashamed of being single, but look for that community. 2020 for me is a year of community. You know, there's some changes that have been happening in my life, and it's just kind of like, kind of almost a fresh start in some ways, but I'm looking for that community. So maybe I'll shoot a couple videos on that, on my, you know, looking for a church at this point, actually, and looking for that community. So maybe I'll shoot some vlog type videos. Let me know in the comments down below if you'd like to see that and follow me on my journey of community and all that. But all that to say, don't be ashamed for being single. It's okay. Don't dwell in self-pity, because God wants to use you where you're at. His timing is perfect. And that's all I have to say today. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, subscribe. Thank you to all my patrons on Patreon. Thank you for supporting this ministry that I can even do this. And it's so amazing that you are supporting me. If you want to support this ministry, it would mean the world to me. Head on over to patreon.com/daily_disciple. And you can sign up to become a gospel partner on Patreon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Leave a comment down below with your thoughts on this. And I'll see you next time. See ya. Just like every other Christian YouTuber, we need our monthly relationship video. Relationship video. Okay, here we go. Christian YouTuber relationship video quota, one per month. Here is my video submission of relationship video to meet the quota. Could you imagine if all my videos were about relationship? You're like, oh my goodness, this guy is really brilliant. He's never been in a relationship, but this dude knows.